Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again, and in this video session I'll discuss FTP from remote to local IBM machine when target save file does not exist. So in my previous video I discussed about FTP from local to IBM remote machine, but this time from remote to local machine. So let's move on to the demo part. Let me open the green screen. So here you can see in this library we don't have any save file object exists, that is easy class 2, but in easy class 1 we have this save file 1 save file object exists. So I just want to transfer this save file from this library to the another library, EB class 2. So here my remote and local machine would be same, and that I would do using the concept of loopback, FTP loopback. So since I don't have any remote machine, so I'll be simulating that here only. So let's treat this machine as a local machine as well as the remote machine, and suppose the remote machine, the save file exists on a remote machine, that is on this library easy class 1, and I want to get it on my local machine, that is on easy class 2 library. So let me do the FTP. So instead of the IP address or the host name, I will give loopback here to perform this thing, and in place of loopback you can input your IP address or the domain name whenever you are performing from FTP from remote IBM to the local IBM. So once I end press enter, session has been started and the loopback address has been connected, as you can see. Now let's enter the user ID and password. So now I'm logged in. Now just use name format 1 so that I can use the format of the fully qualified path, that is name format path, using the QSys lib and then the library and up to the save file. Now I need to transfer the save file in binary mode, so I'll be using bin here to set the representation type as binary. Now I'll use get command here because I want to FTP from remote to the local machine. So I want to get that save file from a remote machine to my local machine from where I am performing this FTP. So get. So instead of put, I will be use get command here, get FTP command. Then I'll be using the fully qualified path since I used name format 1 from this library. And this save file . So you can see that remember this save file 1, in the save file 1 library this exists and it wants me to use a replace. So why it is happening, I just let me tell you that whenever we performing the FTP it won't replace the already existed save file, so we need to use this replace thing in our command to replace the save file if it is already existed. So I'll be showing you that. First let me change this library. So I used easy class 2 here, and then you can see I just transferred my save file from a remote machine, that is on easy class 1 library, to the local IBM using the get command, easy class 2 library. Now the save file has been transferred successfully. Now again let me tell you, if I want to transfer it again, and now my save file is present in easy class 2 library, if I use the same command, I'll get that message again. Remember this in file, this in library, this already exists. Specify replace as a subcommand option. So what I'll do, I'll use the replace. So that would be like something like this, slash replace. So you can see I can use it any number of times. Now I'll not get any message like that. So it, the save file which is already existed in save ed class 2 will now get replaced. So that's how I do the FTP from remote to the IBM local IBM machine. So let's quit from the FTP session and just check. Now you can see the save file has been created in this library. So if I do DSP SAVF display save file on this, save file which has been FTP'd. So this basically save this these much objects as you can see. So that's what that's how the FTP works in case of performing the transfer from a remote to the local IBM I machine when the target save file does not exist. So that's all. Thank you and have a nice time.